It's a beautiful day out here in Medford, Oregon. Usually in the winter, it's kind of rainy here in Medford, but there hasn't been much rain this year. I'm Josiah Douglas. Thank you for watching this video. If it's your first time, I do biblical inspiration and motivation here on YouTube 5 days a week. If that's the kind of thing that you're into, why not hit subscribe and we'll do this every day together. If you have been watching my videos, you've probably been thinking, Josiah, why don't you ever actually read out of the Bible? Well, it's because usually I read my Bible on my phone and, well, I'm using my phone to record this, and so it just gets a little convoluted. But I got my Bible today. God had revealed himself to Moses and was telling him to go back to Egypt and to free the Israelites from the Egyptians. Moses had all kinds of reasons why he couldn't or that he shouldn't, but God told him he needed to anyways. And then here in Exodus 3, 21 and 22, it says, "And I will grant this people favor in the sight of the Egyptians, and it shall be that when you go, you will not go empty-handed. But every woman shall ask of her neighbor and the woman who lives in her house, articles of silver and articles of gold and clothing, and you will put them on your sons and daughters. Thus will you plunder the Egyptians." You see, God wasn't just trying to get the Israelites out of Egypt. He was looking to take care of them after they were gone. Israel and the Jewish people have been one of the richest nations and ethnicities in the world for generations. And the reason is because God wanted to take care of them. Several chapters later, we see that when the Israelites did leave Egypt, this exact thing happened. The people, as they were leaving, they asked the Egyptians for gold and for silver and all kinds of things, and they just said, take them, go, get out of here. Israel left with tons of treasure and tons of money and tons of goods from the Egyptians, just as God had planned it. He planned to provide for his people, not only with miraculous things like manna and ravens and stuff like that in the wilderness, but with literal money that people just gave them as they were leaving. In the New Testament, Jesus gives the example of the birds of the air and the lilies of the field, and he says, you don't need to worry about how to dress or the money and the things that you need because I'm going to provide for you. If you seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, I will provide all these things for you. If you seek God first in building his kingdom, then he's going to provide for you. He might not make you rich or super wealthy or anything like that, but if you seek him first, he's going to provide for you just like he did for the Israelites as they left Egypt. Emily, thank you for watching. Go ahead and hit the like button and leave a comment below. Everybody else, thank you so much for watching. Hit the like button, leave a comment below. If you haven't yet, hit subscribe and hit notifications like Emily did. That way you get notifications every time I come out with a new video like this. I'll see you guys next time.